Hello. It's good to see you. I hope you're doing well. And if not, I hope things turn around for you sooner than later. Welcome to a traditional ASMR video where, as you can tell by the title, this is dedicated to you or anyone watching that may be going through a physical and or a mental or emotional hardship, whether that is recovering from an addiction, alcohol or drugs, whether it's having been bullied, surviving that, still being bullied, whether it's recovering from abuse, domestic abuse, or something more serious like that. While any of my videos can be used for those purposes, and while this video or any other videos can be used just to help you experience some tingles, ASMR, or just relax or sleep, I wanted to dedicate this particular one for those, like I said, that are experiencing a hardship. Okay? And I have here with me Vault Boy, who also wants to help you as well. So, just bear with me. So, I wanted to call this Tending the Wounded. From one survivor to another. I'm only going to guess, not everyone that watches these videos is or has been wounded, but I do know there's quite a lot of folks out there who have been. And I was going to do a role play video called Tending the Wounded. And I forgot I already did one by a stream, so I may do another one as well. But since I haven't done a traditional ASMR video recently since publishing, since this one, I wanted to give this one a little special purpose. Okay, this video, of course, is meant to help you relax, sleep, to bring you peace of mind. Last but not least, and the purpose of this video help you heal. I'll explain in a second. Now, don't think for a second that I think I'm pretentious enough to think that, or have an ego big enough to think that I'm some kind of healer, new age healer, or anything like that. That's not what I mean. I'm sure most of you know me pretty well by now. When I say heal, when I say tending the wounded, basically by allowing yourself, no matter what video it is, even if it's outside of YouTube, in the real world, by allowing yourself, whether you're reading a book, or you're doing something constructive, going for a walk, eating healthy, when you're allowing yourself and your mind to have peace and calm and a very, you know, peaceful state of mind, you're allowing yourself to heal, especially when you sleep, of course. When you sleep, your body heals, right? So the purpose of this video, and like any other ASMR video, is to bring you, give you this moment, this peaceful moment, and to allow yourself to heal. Not like I said, not like a miracle cure or anything like that. And before we go any further, just like the description of this video says, if you are in a really bad place or state of mind, and you have strong urges that negative, you know, suicidal thoughts or things like that, please call a medical professional or a hotline, okay? These videos aren't meant to in no way serve as an alternative, a replacement, but perhaps an additional alternative, or an additional form of something that can help you. Okay, so with that said, we're just going to get started. Speaking of calling someone, I thought, I know a lot of folks enjoy the rotary phone sounds, so I thought I would use this. Not just so that you can enjoy the sounds of it. Maybe it brings back some nostalgia. But also to use it as a message, metaphor, maybe not a metaphor, but a symbol. Don't ever be too proud or stubborn when you feel that you're in a bad state of mind, that you don't think you need help. Pick up the phone. Of course, I'm sure not a rotary phone unless you do. I don't know if they still, if there's rotary phones still in existence, but in any case, you know, and talk to a human being, talk to an expert that's there and I can give you that the time. And that's what they're there for. The professionals are there. So, and beyond the mental health aspect, although still somewhat related, I think it's important to pick up the phone and reach out to someone to make yourself available. If you know someone that could probably use to hear from you, that would like to hear from you. I'm not trying to guilt trip anyone. You know, it can be difficult when we have busy lives, you know, when we have family, when you're dealing with your own issues, right? It's hard to make yourself available to someone else. Everyone, you know, the human race is almost like you look up at the sky, see all the stars, and they're all separated by different, separated by distance and time, and such. And that's like the headspace that everybody's in at any given moment, you know? So it's often easier said than done to just, you know, pick up the phone and call someone. But if you can, you know, we as a species have a lot of work to do when it comes to being a real community. We tend, especially when it comes to mental health. I know that we like to ignore, pretend things. We like to say people can just get over it, you know? And there's a lot of stigma, you know, involved. But, you know, we can only do our best. And I also think that you should pick up the phone and reach out to someone to try to there's a rift between you and like a family member or a friend, you know? Again, don't be too proud or too stubborn or even too guilty, you know, whatever the case might be, the situation, to reach out and try to repair a bridge that may have been broken. When it comes to interacting with one another. I can tell you that growing up, born in the 70s, we had a rotary phone. So I'm just going to lift off the handle, and I actually want to move on. I don't want to spend too much time on any one thing, but I had a rotary phone growing up, 7-digit number, and then they introduced the area code, and everyone was freaking out, you know. But sometimes I think that we need to use the phone for the reason it was invented. Sometimes It seems like we use the phone to talk at each other more than we talk with each other. But, yeah, I'm guilty as charged. But I don't want to do a whole big political thing. It's just an observation, you know. Anyway, that's, we all do it, you know, but. The next thing I wanted to do is for those who may be struggling with self-harm, a couple folks, and I don't mean to use red, a couple folks, and I've read it, and I've seen, glimpsed some articles. I'm no expert, but those that struggle or with self-harm, they say that use a marker when you feel the need or those urges to use a marker. And I would not could be an expert, of course, but I would like to say that if you are struggling with self-harm, that please try not to hurt yourself for whatever reason it might be. Respect yourself. You I'm not going to try to begin to guess the reasons why someone might harm themselves. Okay, there's a lot of, could be guilt, could be self-esteem, confidence, self-worth, abuse related. But if you are, you know, whoever that this message can reach, you don't hurt yourself. You respect, you don't hurt yourself because of that you feel you, whatever it might be. I would like to think that you deserve to live happy life. And when I say I like to think, because I know sometimes folks may make mistakes, end up in jail or prison. Does that make them, you know, whether it's theft, whether it's something else, does that mean that they don't no longer deserve a shot at redemption? Now, I don't want to get too political when it comes to some very serious crimes, but I'm talking more some minor things where you go and you serve some time, you know, you've done your time and now you're trying to make things right and all that. Okay, you know, I'm a strong believer in second chances, you know, third chance, you know, third chance. I don't know how many chances, right? But I think everyone has deserves a shot at redemption. I have a little bit of a, I don't want to get too political. I have a little bit of an issue with the prison system. We should promote reform and education and more healthcare and things like that. But, you know, there's a lot of different reasons that folks do things, but I don't want to spend too much time talking about prison. That's not really the point. The point is to try to touch on a reason why someone might self-harm, if it's out of guilt or something like that. So moving away from prison, you know, if it's, if you have been bullied, it's tough. But with time, you can heal. But don't hurt yourself, you know. You deserve to be happy. You deserve your body. You deserve respect. And you need to realize that. You need to have some confidence. And, you know, I'm not an expert on maybe, I might not be an expert on, I'm trying to do these at the same time. So I just need to, my arms are getting tired a little bit. But I may not be an expert on what it might take to help someone. But I have a lot of street knowledge, street cred. When it comes to doing what it takes to build confidence and self-esteem and respecting yourself. And you deserve that. I'm going to say that you're not someone like a mass murderer, okay? So because when I say that, you probably deserve. I don't know everyone that's watching this video, of course. I just can't. I'm not going to just make a blanket statement. But I'm pretty sure most of us here, most folks watching, are good people, you know? Everyone makes mistakes, but for the most part, we're good people. And that you deserve to, you deserve to have respect for yourself, to be happy. You deserve a happy life just like anybody else, you know? So, like I said, I'm just stumbling a little for words because I want to make sure I don't say anything that I'm not too knowledgeable about, but still get the message across. All right? So, why don't we move on to the next thing? That's it, really, for the messages that I have. I just wanted to, you know, say that. I'll try something new, see if this works. Some shaving cream, put it in this shaving cream cup. So I thought this might make some nice sounds. Gotta switch my hands here. Give you a shave, but you know, maybe next time. Besides, you might be a woman or a girl and might not need a shave. That'd be kind of awkward. just probably can't hear it too well, but just going like this. So I hope that you've been well for the most part. You know, life is full of surprises, ups and downs, and there's no instructions. It's not perfect. We all can only do our best from day to day, sometimes moment to moment. Never say, I may in the past have said, it will get better. I can't say that. No one can say that. I would like to think that it will get better for you. I would like to think that it can get better. Even if it's with your, by your own doing, if it takes some effort from your part. Sometimes just time. They say time heals all wounds, and it took me, you know, 30, 35, 40 years for my wounds to be healed from bullying, you know, to where I can actually think about the guy that, or the people that used to give me a hard time. And forgive them. Because we were all young and stupid and didn't know. We were all dealing with issues. No, no one's born a bully, you know? No one's born a murderer. We're all innocent children, and then something happens to us. Sometimes it's genetics. Sometimes it's a predisposition to something. You know, so many different variables and cases of why someone might do the things they do. And just like the people of my past, you know, different people picked on me. Maybe one person might have been a particular bully. Were they all bullies? Maybe because all different people picked on me, I felt I was being bullied. But as an individual, were they really bullies? You know? Maybe I was just the only one. Maybe everyone found me to be a target, right? So, I have some matches. And even the bully deserves a shot at redemption. That's how we move forward. It's how we evolve as a species, as a race. Learning from our mistakes and trying to teach. Certain behaviors are not accepted. You know, bullying, you know, more extreme acts, domestic abuse, you know, things like that. So I have some matches. I'm gonna light a candle. Dedicate it to you, to all the folks out there, dealing with something. You know, and as I make this video, it's April. From what I understand, April is now or in some autism awareness month, if I'm not mistaken. So, a big shout out to all the folks that help those with autism. The real, one of the real heroes. Those who have a family member or just work in a, you know, or a caregiver in some manner. Like, you know, like a babysitter that takes care of someone who has autism, whether it's, you know, no matter how severe. So, that kind of compassion and strength sometimes. I can imagine one of my patients. So I'm going to light this candle. So, dedicate this to you, to those out there who may be struggling with a hardship of some kind, to those out there who are helping those with hardships, to those out there, you know, trying to make their lives better, trying to make someone else's life better. to say one thing about the prison system. Is that we can't, the mentality of just locking people away. I think that's part of the problem that we have when it comes to a lot of things that people do, mistakes. We can't be accountable. We can't hold people accountable for the rest of their lives for a mistake that they made. Now, it depends on how heinous the crime is, but when it comes to some certain things, and let me give you an example of why I say this. Have you heard of Reginald Denny? I don't know if you remember the LA riots back in the, was it the 90s? And I'm not sure if that was around, was that Rodney King? I forget. It was a white guy driving a trailer through a part of LA where the riots occurred. Let me just say that. He was going through an intersection. All this stuff was going on. He got pulled out of his trailer. And he was beat pretty badly. Very disturbing to watch. But I don't know how many years it was later. 10 years later. He did an interview. And he said he forgave the folks that did what they did to him. And I said to myself, and this was in my mid-20s, still a lot of pent-up anger from, you know, being what I went through. How could you forgive someone for something like that? And it's not, you know, wanting to be friends with them. It's not that it was okay, but he made peace with it. And however, you know, he did. And that's why I mentioned the prison system. And I'm not even a religious person. I don't really care one way or the other if there's a God exists, it doesn't. That's really, I couldn't be, it doesn't matter to me. Compassion, empathy, forgiveness. You know, that's important. You know, so I just want to say that. You know, all right. So, let's move on. a little loud. Make sure it's not. It's going to do it for the paper cups. How about just